very warm welcome to all of you. It is truly an auspicious start of the new year, and our good wishes for the new year, not only to you, sir, to the entire fraternity out here. So the Guru series of talks, what we have been holding for the last year and a half now, is basically that we call the Gurus of Guru, also the captains of any particular field. And today, for all of you, when you say start with the word Swami, Swami itself means Guru. So we would have had a better person to start this particular year, as far as we are all concerned. So once again, a very warm welcome, sir. It is part of the Yogananda Knowledge Initiative which we had started. There is so much one can say about Swamiji. Swamiji itself says a lot. But what I am going to say is something beyond that. And I am sure you would have seen it in the resume which I had made to all of you. Now this will excite the intellectuals sitting out here. He is an engineer by profession, electronics and communication engineering from IIT Kharagpur. Not only in school, but subsequently also from Kharagpur in the engineering part. And subsequently he joined as the HAM as a senior research assistant, and subsequently also followed it up with a little stint of teaching. But when he was a senior scientist at the Center of Navigation Electronics, that was the time life changed. I will not say life changed, or perhaps there was a radical change. A lot of people would have loved to take up the offer what Swamiji was given to join the missile team of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He chose otherwise. And that is the time he joined the satsang as a sannyasi. So it is a very different world. There is so much to learn. So I would request all of you to have a very good interactive question and answer session subsequently. Because he is going to speak to you something which is very different from science being science and spirituality being spirituality. How the two have got a fusion with each other. How the two merge and what influence it has on our lives is something which I think all of us need to be educated on, sir. And once again, sir, a very warm welcome to you. May I request you to do the honors.
Prosperous New Year to each one of you.
Thank you.
Thank you. You won't understand how joyful I am to be here, because visiting any education institution means hope coming for me. Because before I joined the ashram as a sannyasi, almost all my life has been spent in universities, schools, either as a student, a research scholar, or as a teacher. So a school is a home for me. So I am very happy to be among such bright, young, energetic faces today. Science and spirituality. See, everything in this world is being pursued scientifically. Don't you agree? Be it studies, it should be scientific learning. Be it management, it should be systematic and scientific. Be it games, even learning, it should be scientific. How to put the step forward. Now everything is scientific. So even religion, spirituality should be pursued scientifically. What is meant by pursuing spirituality scientifically? Very simple. To apply well-tested methods to get well-defined results. Now that is science. Well-tested methods should be applied to get well-defined results. Maitreya Upanishad says, from joy we have come for joy, we live. In that sacred joy, one day we shall meet again. In a world of duality, where we see so much pain and suffering all around us, such a statement may sound unrealistic. Isn't it so? We see so much pain and suffering. Is it possible that I have come from joy and I can live in joy? We may not be able to fully grasp the import of such a statement right now. But if only we practice the principles well mapped out by ancient rishis, in time we will watch for the veracity of such a statement. Upanishad cannot go wrong. It can't be a false statement. Possibly it's our perception that with our intellect we may not be able to catch the meaning. But slowly, slowly, if you pursue scientifically, religion, practice of religion, if you want to introduce science, simple thing is yoga. Yoga is the science of religion. People get carried away, or people get, they turn away from religion, because religion normally we think it is just a set of rituals. Isn't it so? Set of rituals, do this, do that, visit that, visit. If you limit religion to that, yes, it is ritual. Nothing much, satisfying, fine. But if you see the core of religion, that is yoga. Yoga, if you practice yoga, then you see the science behind religion. Yes, we cannot have one religion throughout this universe. That's not possible. It changes from place to place, from time to time. But yoga, that is same. Yoga means literally union. Union. What is union? Union of this living self with the higher spirit. Union of this living self with God. I mean, that is yoga. That is what we should scientifically practice. Scientifically. Yoga, not many people, yoga means a set of asanas, no? Physical postures. That is just one system of yoga, Hatha yoga. It's very good, very beneficial for physical and mental health. But real yoga is something beyond that. Any procedure that helps to connect my little self with infinite spirit. That infinite spirit means all knowledge, all wisdom, perfect love, unconditional joy. That's what I want to get attached to. For that, the procedure is yoga. Taitiya Rishi said that I can live in joy perpetually. In Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna says, Smarananda Giri Dharmasya Rayate Mahato Bhaya, meaning, even a little practice of this yoga meditation will save you from dire fears. Svarthamapasya dharmasya, meaning a little practice of this yoga meditation. Prayate mahato bhaya, meaning saves you from dire fears, great fears. It seems, as long as we have life, what is guaranteed is anxiety. That is guaranteed, isn't it so? Be it a 10-year-old boy, or a 20-year-old youth, a 30-year-old service holder, a housewife, a retired person, everyone, what next? I mean, that what next? Be it an examination, or service, or this, or that, or health, or what? That is there, isn't it so that? What next? It's possible to live a life free from such anxiety, stress. Eventually, if you are practicing yoga meditation, what happens is, no matter what's happening around me, no matter what's happening to me, I can still be joyful. Because joy is my true nature. Now, that is there, that each one of us, it's possible. No matter what's happening around us, no matter what's happening to us, still we can be joyful. Live a life free from stress, free from anxiety, fear, worry. We cannot change the events around us. They are there. But our reaction to the events can change. We don't have the anxious and fearful. That is what is possible with yoga. I will share a story. One person had a lot of difficulties, mainly financial difficulties. And because of financial difficulties, other problems also are there. He tried and tried, somehow he couldn't dissolve. One night he had a dream where God appeared to him and said, go to the outskirts of the town. There you will find a sadhu. Ask him. He will give you a diamond that would solve your problem. The next morning before the sun rose, he rushed to the outskirts. There to his present surprise, he saw a sadhu on a tree. He went and asked, diamond. Sadhu did not understand. Because sadhu did not have a dream. He had a dream. So he said, then he explained. Then he said, oh, now I understand. Few days back when I was moving in the forest, there I found a diamond. This is what how the God was referring. So he from his shoulder bag took it out and gave it to me. That was so huge, so rare, so precious. This diamond would have solved all of his problems and problems of his children and their children. It is so big and huge. He took it. That night he went home and he could not sleep. He was tossing around his bed. Next day morning, he rushed back to the sadhu and said, return the diamond, please take it. Why? Lord asked to take from you. I have given it wholeheartedly. Why are you returning it? Then he said, there is something in you by which you are able to give away this diamond so easily. I want that something. Now, if I want to donate 500 rupees to someone, I must have more than 500 rupees with me. So you are able to give away this diamond so easily, there is something in you by which you are able to give away this so easily. I want that something. That is inner security. Then this diamond is useful even for a sadhu. Material prosperity and social status and health insurance and all that, you know, it is useful for him. But he could give away. So there is something. The inner security. Inner security. I mean, that is what we are all looking for. And it's possible to get hooked to that inner security scientifically. It's not arbitrary. We can do that. That is yoga. Another example, mundane example I can quote is this. Suppose you have fever. Go to the doctor. Doctor gives you a tablet, paracetamol. And if you take 8 hours early or 6 hours early, it reduces the temperature. But is it all what a doctor gives you? No. He gives another tablet. What is that? Antibiotic. No. This paracetamol may reduce the temperature, giving you symptomatic relief. But until the bacteria which causes this temperature is removed, there is no real cure. Don't you agree? That bacteria has to be removed. So that's an antibiotic also is given. That is the root cause of that temperature. So that has to be removed. Similarly, I have some problem, financial problem. I have family problem, I have professional problem, I have social problem, relationship problem. These problems are there. But if I try to resolve this problem, it comes again later. Or it may be resolved, some other problem is there, some other problem is there. Try to understand where is the root cause of these problems. There is some root cause which is giving these problems. Bacteria is there which give this temperature. What is root cause? That is ignorance, ajnana. Ignorance of real self, ignorance of divinity. That divinity is there in me. That divinity is there. That I am not aware. When I am not aware of the divinity, these problems are going to be there. So that has to be removed. Not just that, in addition to resolving the problems, that ajnana also has to be removed. That is the real solution. Each one of us is looking for. Let me put it another way. I have this body. I take care of this body by right food, right exercise. When I take care of this body, in turn, body gives me health and mobility. So I have responsibility to the body. Body gives something to me in turn. But I also have a mind. I have to cultivate my mind too by contemplation and intellectual pursuits. By deep study, I have to cultivate my mind. If I do that, in turn, mind gives me intelligence. Yet to do the attack, let alone with others. Isn't it so? But many people stop here. They take care of their bodies, they take care of their minds. But there is one more faculty, that is soul. Man is a threefold nature, body, mind and soul. And we have to nourish the soul too, properly. When we nourish the soul, how do we nourish the soul? Meditation, yoga. Yoga meditation is the food for soul, deep contemplation. That is the soul for, that is the food for soul. When we cultivate, when we nourish the soul properly, in turn, soul gives me something. What is that? Intuition. Unconditional joy, perfect love, wisdom. These things come, creativity. These things come from soul. Creativity is not, it's not coming from the mind, it comes from soul. And if I cultivate soul properly, I become more creative in life. Whatever may be your station in life, whatever may be your profession, you can get more creative if you are cultivating that soul properly. And how do you nourish the soul? Meditation, yoga meditation. So that we have to have the all-round development of body, mind and soul. Then only you can expect to be perfectly happy in this world. That's where many of us fall short. Take care of body, take care of mind, and they think that that's all what we need to do. No, there is something more. That soul, realize, acknowledge the existence of soul inside, and take care of it. Take care of it. Then only you are perfect. You are complete. I digress and answer, address one question. What is God? What is God? I mean, that's it. God is something we have been hearing from childhood, a concept we are asked to believe, or something which we don't pay attention. It's okay. Not that we believe or we don't believe. We just don't pay attention. But what is God? Did we ever stop and contemplate? There are many, many definitions and descriptions of God. Books are written, lectures spoken. But to me personally, the definition closest to my heart is this. God is Satchidananda. God is Satchidananda. That's the definition of God I like most. What is Satchidananda? You have to understand. Satchidananda is again a word we have been hearing. We name our children Satchidananda. But did they understand what it is? Let me explain. God, now I don't know any concept of God. God, even if I don't know anything about God, whether God is He, or She, or It, whatever it is, if there is something like, someone like God, can that God be sorrowful? No. Even if you don't know anything about it, let we can assume that God is joy, God is bliss, God is joy. But to say God is joy, God is Ananda, is a gross understatement. God is not simple joy. Because joy we are familiar is so different. If I take a mango, it gives me joy. A second mango gives me further joy. Third mango may not give me the same joy. Isn't it so? Fourth one, I don't want to take. Fifth time, I keep the person who gives me. I mean, that the theory of diminishing returns, the theory of marginal utility. That's applicable not only to mangoes, items. Every experience in this universe, every item in this universe is, isn't it so? When something you like, once, twice, thrice, slowly it fades, that interest fades. But there is something in this creation which never goes stale. That is God Kanta. God is not just joy, He is ever new joy. Nitya Navina. The joy of God, when you contact God, is so new. It's so new, it's Nitya Navina every time. That is why we see devotees meditating. In meditation, devotee tries to contact the joy, God as joy. And someone may say that yesterday I saw him meditating, day before I saw him meditating, why not he leave today? No, it's so new again. It's ever new. God is Nitya Navina. That's the only thing in this world which is ever new. That is God, God's joy, ever new joy. Okay. God may be giving you joy, but what good it is if he is not aware of his joy. God